how significant is this launch?
It's huge from a practical basis, but also from a propaganda perspective as well. So from a, more practical perspective, this is actually the second crewed mission sent to the International Space Station after it was completed just a few months ago. And they needed to send three astronauts up there to replace the three others who are coming back. And the goal is actually to have the space station operate continuously, just like the International Space Station that the U.S. sort of runs. And so that's the practical consideration. But then from other broader perspective, China is facing a lot of intense competition from a lot of countries. Besides the U.S., you have even countries like South Korea, which recently launched a rocket. And then the U.S., you've got a dozen countries that are signed up for Artemis Accords, which regulate space activity, right? And the U.S. developed that one. And then you've got private space companies like SpaceX, which Elon Musk owns, right? And they sent four astronauts to space early this month.
Alan, in the grand scheme of things, do we have China planning to actually put a man on the moon by 2030? How far does this mission take them there?
Exactly. That's what I announced yesterday, the space agency announced yesterday. And it's just the latest of several achievements. Back in 2019, they sent a craft to the moon, 2021, sent a rover to Mars. So this one will actually make it, by sending a crewed mission to the International Space Station, will make it with their enough knowledge and expertise to actually send a crewed mission to the moon by 2030.